Today, we're kicking off an exclusive month-long daytime event called American Idol Then and Now. Throughout the next few weeks, we're going to be looking back and catching up with some of the most famous winners and contestants from American Idol. We're going back to where it all started with that golden ticket to Hollywood. And to kick us off, it's the original idol, Kelly Clarkson.
All right, time to start.
Kelly first came into the public's eye in 2002 when she made it through round after round of auditions for the new hit show, American Idol. The Texas-born singer with a powerhouse voice wowed judges and audience members alike as she flew through week after week of jaw-dropping performances, ultimately granting her the title and prestige of becoming the first American Idol. In the wake of her success at Idol, Kelly continued on to record her first solo record, Thankful, in 2003. However, it was her 2004 effort, Breakaway, that ended up winning her two Grammys and cemented her as one of the leading pop stars in the world. Since then, Kelly has gone on to record five other albums, breaking records, and winning more awards along the way. She's performed all over the world and for some of the biggest names of our time, including President Obama and the Pope. In 2013, she married a longtime friend and son of her manager, and the couple now have two beautiful children together.
With seven albums under her belt, over 25 million albums sold worldwide, 91 number ones on the Billboard charts, and 11 international number one singles, Kelly Clarkson will always have a special place in her heart for American Idol. Take a look. So I have a couple of idol questions for you.
Okay.
So that must be obviously such incredible memories for you,
yeah.
Such an amazing part.
Probably my favorite one, you were present for, yeah, the ending, like with all, that was pretty
That's
magical.
That's right,
for me, so yeah.
with you and Justin. And,
no, the ending, I was pregnant.
And then you went up and sang Piece by Piece,
yes.
Which was one of the great performances I think I felt for you because I could.
It's hard to sing when you're so emotional.
Yes, it is.
Yes, and I had like crazy pregnant hormones on top of the fact that I'm already kind of crazy. Like I thought I cried the entire time and it was like a sobbing mess.
It felt like you were on the verge of a complete breakdown,
yeah.
And you were holding it together, which I think is ultimately more difficult for an audience to watch than if you had just totally broke down.
Yes.
You were trying to hold it together.
It's like watching Rudy.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. So do you think you'd be anywhere near where you are now had American Idol not come into your life in terms of a career?
I obviously don't fit the norm of what people really expect, so I don't know if I would have been able to make it to where I am now, but my goal was to be a background singer. So
is that right?
Yeah, so I feel like I would have done that, but...
I see, I disagree with you only because of when you went and auditioned. I saw that tape not long ago,
yeah.
And there's an incredible charisma and confidence about you when you first walked into the room with Simon, Randy, and Paula.
Yeah.
That's obviously a superstar.
But I mean, and also the charisma was because I had no home and my place just burned down and I was like, you will perform, monkey.
Right.
You will make them love you.
And you did.
I needed it to work.
Yeah. Is there anybody that you put yourself on stage next to and said, this would have been tough to win against
Ruben.
This person? Ruben.
And he was the second one, but yeah, Ruben would have been hard.
Because?
I feel like there are nights when I can be effortless, and those are amazing, and I feel like, oh my God, I'm amazing, but he is effortless every time.
Do you ever find when you come off stage that you thought you were the most amazing thing ever, and you kind of got a whatever response?
Yes!
And vice versa?
Yes!
Happens all the time,
yes.
Right?
Yes!
So you thought...
I can't even say I say this all the time. I'm like, I feel like I just nailed it, and everybody's like, meh.
Yeah,
and then,
your band,
and every,
the audience may... Well,
yes.
The audience is going to love you, but you know what I'm talking about.
No, even the audience, they're like, that was the most amazing night. I'm like, I was like actually like Janis Joplin, like and not in a good way. Like, it was not good.
I actually went up to one of my band members one time. I thought it was one of the best shows I'd ever given. And I walked off stage, and nobody said anything, and I went up to my friend Jeff. I said, Jeff, was that not pretty darn good? He goes... Yeah. I'm like, what?
And you're like, I'm not even going to try.
Yeah, for yeah. Sure. It's a
and
weird...
And then people are like, are you fishing for a compliment? I'm like, absolutely. Validate me.
You know what Keith Urban told me something one time? He said, sometimes we're hearing things for what they're not as opposed to what they are. So if you sing something and you don't think it's particularly good, you're hearing all the stuff wrong with it.
Yeah.
And you don't have the ability to hear it for what
yeah.
it is.
Exactly. Because you get in your own way.
If you had to remember one... best piece of advice from any of the Idol judges. Do you remember what it was? Anything that stuck with you?
I feel like I was that contestant that, like, I was just under the radar. Like, nobody really, you know, gave me advice. I don't know if I'm impressing anyone, but I'm not impressing them. Mm-hmm. So I'll just stay right here.
Was like, Simon tough on you?
No. I think the best thing that Simon said actually to me was offstage. And I don't know if I've ever said this before, but he said, I came up and I was like, okay, every week I think that you're going to just lay into me. Like, when can you just do it? And he said, I just know you won't care. Like, he's like, I know it's not going to affect you.
Would
like,
it have?
No, like he'd almost try and poke at people, I feel like, just to see what their reaction would be as a human.
Sure.
Because there's a lot more to just being a singer.
Sure.
Like you're an artist and people want to know your personality as well. And he was like, I just don't think it would have affected you.
If you had to pick like just three people over the course of American Idol's history that you say these people are extraordinarily talented.
Oh, geez, there's so many. I'm a big Ruben fan.
Yeah, he's still
okay. Yeah, Ruben's probably my favorite. I was a big fan of RJ Helton, and I felt like he was like the male Mariah Carey. He was amazing. And Tamir Gray.
Kelly, it's
Thank
great
you.
To see you.
Thank you so much.
Best of luck
again.
With Baby Rem.
Thanks for being here, Kelly.